y'all, Philly Diva coming to you, and I want to just first say that this will probably be the first and last video like this. Not videos ever. This is probably going to be the last video and the first video that I make like this. And what I mean by this, I mean by the title, using the word type. I try my best throughout my natural hair journey not to go, you know, follow that whole typing system, but I figure this is the easiest way because most people do follow it. But I want to talk about the type 4 hair, and I want to talk about, you know, what's going on right now in the natural hair community here on YouTube, because we all pretty much follow each other in some fashion or form. Somebody tells you to go watch this person or whatever, even though if you're not subscribed, you end up watching somebody's video. But I want to kind of talk about what's going on YouTube in the natural hair community. I've been catching up on a lot of my videos, and I've been noticing, like, you know, a lot of things going on and scratching my head and laughing at the same time about what's going on, because I think what the consensus is that there really isn't enough representation of type 4 natural hair divas here on YouTube. And going forward, I want to change the direction of my channel, obviously. Going forward, you're probably going to hear me refer to my hair as thick and kinky, because that's how I describe my hair. But for this video purpose, I'm going to say type, okay? Type 4s, A, B, and C, whatever you want to say. So, again, like I said, I'm getting the feeling that there's kind of a consistency that there isn't enough representation of type 4 natural hair on YouTube. And in a way I agree with it, in a way I kind of disagree with it. The reason why I disagree with, well, let me start with why I agree. I agree with it because when I first came onto YouTube, I agree 100% with that. I felt like, you know, I was watching all these natural hair divas and I was like, oh, my hair looks just like this. Oh, her hair is so cute. Oh, my hair twists out to come like that. And being ignorant to the natural hair world, being ignorant to the different types of natural hair, just being ignorant to the whole process itself, did not realize that even though somebody may have the same type of hair, within that type, my hair is still different from the next person. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, if I have type 4 hair and you have type 4 hair, your hair is still different from mine's. If I do a twist out on my type 4 hair and you do a twist out on your type 4 hair, your twist out is not going to look like my twist out. Do you understand what I'm saying? And I think the problem that a lot of us is having, including myself, we far too often want things to be like somebody else's. And we got to break away from that. That is my whole new vision. Stop trying to make myself, my hair, whatever, appear like someone else's, because in reality, it's never going to be. It's never going to be. Even if I had a twin sister, her hair would be different from mine. It's just the way God made us, and that's just the way we have to accept it. So the reason why I say that I disagree with there isn't enough representation now, because I feel like people like myself, with type 4 hair, I feel like there's people like African Export, there's people like Kimmy Tube has type 4 hair, there's people like Curly Chronicles, Rustic Beauty, She Sings Lovely. I mean, the list goes on of how many different types. Natalie Ever After, there's so many. Tony Daly, like, there's so many YouTubers that are on here that represent that type of hair, and I don't want to say we don't give each other enough credit, but I think we just need to dig a little deeper beyond, you know, what we're accustomed and what we're used to seeing. No offense to, you know, all those natural hair gurus. Speaking of gurus, hold on the video on that one. But I think we fall in the trap where we see, and I mean, this is why I hate this typing system, because I think most of us, and I'm not gonna say most of us, I'm gonna speak for myself. This is Philly Diva speaking for Philly Diva and nobody else. Personally, when I think of natural hair, or my thought process of what natural hair, what I wanted my natural hair to look like, it's type 3. I'm not even going to fake it, I'm going to keep it funky with y'all. Type 3 hair. That's what I wanted, and that's what I thought was, like, nice and gorgeous. But reality check, Diva, you don't have type 3 hair, okay? You have type 4 hair, which is kinky and thick, okay? And it took me almost 2 years, 20 months and counting, to realize that my thick, kinky hair is just as gorgeous. It's just as fly. It's just as natural as type 3, 2, or type 1 hair, okay? Natural hair is just unprocessed hair, no matter what type it is. So, for me, personally, a part of my journey was really accepting my hair for what it is. Accepting my hair for what it is. That was step one, accepting it. Step two, learn it. Okay? One, accept it. Two, learn it. Three, love it. Because, I mean, this is the hair that you're going to get. This is what you're stuck with unless you're going to shave it all off. And guess what? If you shave it all off, it's going to grow back to the same thing, boobs. So it's like you have to just deal with what God has blessed you with. God has blessed you with that head of hair. Some people ain't got no hair at all, y'all. Come on. Okay? So right now, I'm just like scratching my head on a lot of these videos that people are putting up. I don't want to make any video responses to anything. I mean, because some of the videos is funny as hell. But there's a lot of videos up. I'm sure y'all know what I'm talking about. People, you know, in a rant, and you know, they're getting upset about, you know, other people trying to help them out, and you know, leave them alone. Like, if they don't do hair, leave them alone. You know, let them do them. Everybody that's on YouTube is here for a purpose. I'm here for a reason. You know, you're here for a reason. Whatever it may be, everybody's here on YouTube for a reason. And I feel like this whole natural hair thing is like blowing way out of proportion. I mean, yeah, it's a wonderful thing, but it's like, stop. Stop. Because I really was feeling like a lot of the videos that are posted right now, especially about people like getting on your nerves about the whole situation. Because when I remember far back when I first went natural, I ain't gonna lie, like, I was the biggest crybaby about my hair. I couldn't find anything that worked. My hair was dry, it was short, it was brittle, it was just, I ain't like it at all, okay? Let me just put it out there. And people were just like, oh, Diva, you gotta try this. Oh, Diva, try this product. Oh, Diva, you gotta do this. Everybody was telling me what to use. And naive me, I was going out buying all these products, spending money, and the stuff didn't work. Okay? It didn't work. And then it was like, oh, Diva, you gotta check out so-and-so channel. Okay? So-and-so has type 3 hair. Okay? Why? Well, I'll check out so-and-so with type 3 hair. Well, ain't a lick of type 3 hair on my head. Then people was coming at me, was like, oh, Diva, you gotta do your hair like this and let the water run through it. Hold your head down and shake it like a dog. Stop. Like, stop. Seriously, stop. People, pump the brakes. Seriously. A whole natural hair journey is just what it is. It's a journey. And while it is great to have resources, while it's great to have support and feedback and, you know, and sites to refer to, at the end of the day, that natural hair journey is yours and is exactly what it is. It's a journey, okay? If you know what a journey is, a natural hair journey is a journey. Trust me, because you go through so many different phases that it's life-changing. And I mean, I know some people like Philly, it is not that deep. It really is. It really is. And it was for me. And I'm speaking for myself. It really was a life-changing thing for me, because I've been relaxed. I've been processed practically half my life. Being natural, I was natural when I was a baby, 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I got my first perm when I was like, my first relaxer when I was like 7. And I've been natural now almost 2 years. So I've been natural for 9 years of my life. I'm 35 years old. So I've been relaxed majority of my life. So learning what it takes to maintain natural hair is a process. It's a journey, and it's mine, okay? Let me enjoy it. Allow me to experiment. Allow me to, you know, to learn my hair. I appreciate people when they refer me to things, that products, and different people, but I got this. And I think a lot of people feel that way now. Like, you get to a point where it's like, okay, let me just do me. And let me just take this journey by myself. And sometimes you just have to do that. And I mean, I really feel for the people that are newly natural. Because I wish I had someone telling me this, you know, 2 years ago. But I mean, it's okay. You live and you learn. I feel like now, you know, I really do got this. I'm so proud of my natural hair now. And it's finally clicked to me that, you know, all it really takes is keeping my hair clean, keeping my hair moisturized, and protecting it. That's all it takes. There's no special trick to it. You know, it's just really just keeping it clean, keeping it moisturized, protecting it, finding those great products that work for your hair, okay? Not my hair, work for your hair, and stick with it. That's all it is, baby. I'm telling you. And for all my kinky, thick, type 4 divas, please stand up. Trust me, you're not alone, okay? You're not alone. And there are products out there that work for you. There are products that, I don't want to say help your hair grow, but there are products that help you with moisturization, because for type 4 hair, the key to it is moisture. I mean, it's probably key to all hair, but definitely for type 4 hair, the key is moisture. We have to keep our hair moisturized 24/7, otherwise it's a wrap. It's a wrap! Seriously, like, and I learned that. I learned that when my hair is dry, it's a hot mess. It's a hot mess. But when it's moist, baby, as my girl Dre on TV would say, baby, I love it to death. Seriously. Speaking of my girl Drea on TV, I want to point out and shout out a few natural divas that probably some of you didn't even know were natural. Again, my girl Drea on TV, Songbird Diva, Eccentric Diva, Muffin is My Lover, Thomas Adriana, the list goes on. There's so many divas out there that are natural that we would probably, you would never know, but they are natural, because people automatically assume when you're natural that you're supposed to just wear your hair out all the time. No, okay? You can wear wigs, you can wear weaves, you can wear anything that you want. It's your hair, you can do you, okay? So just keep that in mind. And also keep in mind, CMP, clean, moisturize, protect, that is the key. If you look at gurus like Kimmy Tube, Rustic Beauty, Curly Chronicles, Brown Baby Doll, all those divas who have great lengths, they have natural hair and they have great lengths because they keep their hair clean, moisturized, and protect. That's it. That's like ding dong. That's the key. I'm telling you guys. Trust me. It works. It works. It works. You just gotta get a regimen. You gotta just keep a regimen. Be consistent, and that's all it really takes, you guys. So this whole natural hair thing, some of y'all be tripping. You know it. Stop tripping. I know it's your hair, but you have to do what's best for you. And don't fall into all those traps and, you know, start becoming product junkies. If you are a product junkie, go to rehab, okay? Because you only need a few key essential products to really maintain a healthy head of hair, okay? And don't forget, CMP, baby. CMP! Clean, moisturize, protect. All right, talk to you guys later. Bye.